the Audi E-Tron SUV charge port. Check that out. Now, right here, they got a little charge status indicator light. You've got the standard J1772. And if you flip down this little door here, you have DC fast charging with the combo. So we're going to plug in its mobile charger. It's actually on a 110 outlet, 15 amp. So this is just a J1772. Plug that in there. And there it goes. We got a white flashing light. And once charging actually starts, that's going to change colors. So we're going to watch and wait for that. We got green. Now there's a few different charge statuses. We got red, something's wrong. Yellow, looks like no power. Solid, full battery. Intermittent, looks like that would probably be a timer function. So power, but it's not charging, or it's charging on a timer. And then the pulsing, you know, dim and bright, which is what's happening now, would be active charging. Now let's back up and look at the actual screen. And not too sure how to get exactly what we're looking for, but we are charging in progress. We got 215 miles. Don't know if that's rated miles, ideal miles, or what. This vehicle has not yet undergone EPA testing, so they cannot give a straight answer as to yet. Let me see if I can bring up some more information. There we go. Shows 93%. There's a view button right here. It's charging at a half mile per hour, probably because looks like climate controls, air conditioning's on. Yeah, when it's going to be negative 20 tonight. So we're going to shut that off, and now we can see that's going up. We're charging at 800 watts. I do not know what the maximum wattage is on a 110 outlet. Let's see if I can get to a different screen here. Looks like it'll take another 10 hours, 48 minutes for a full charge. And I can, let's see. Exit warning malfunction. Once again, this is a demo car that's been through who the heck knows what. Not connected to Bluetooth. Oh, then we can pull up nav. But I would rather see some more charging details. But I do not know how to get to that. Oh, there we go. And that just shows me exactly what we're already looking at. Settings, vehicle. Let's see, vehicle. Oh, charging and efficiency. That's what we're looking for. Charging progress. There. 93%. Targets 100. Advanced charging settings. Yep. No advanced settings have been stored yet. Okay. Let's see. Will it show a DC connector? Unlock after charging has ended. Okay, so it looks like we have to unlock the charging plug for the DC fast charging after we're done charging. It's a little... Oh, there we go. Oh, check that out. Not too intuitive. I guess I missed the tiny little page buttons right there. Charge scheduling. Love that. Let's see, does it give us more options on that? Nope, back to that again. Oh, there we go. Now we can select anywhere from 50 to 100%, which is pretty much standard. I don't blame them that they're charging it to 100%, considering that there's not too many stations yet that the Audi can fast charge on in the area. So now to answer my viewer's other question, we're gonna exit the vehicle and go around to the other side. I had somebody ask if there were actually two charge ports. There are not, or actually I should say it's yes and no. Two charge ports, you got both the AC and DC in one spot right there. But this is a US spec charge port. Now, yes, it's a German spec car, but they put the US charge port on it right there. But if we go around to the other side,
there is an identical panel on this side. Now, for the Euro spec and Asian spec car, this is actually where the charge port would be, on this side. So basically what's on the other side would be mirrored onto this side, only with that country or continent's specific charge port style. There are not two charge ports, which is something I'd actually be a proponent for. I'd be 100% for a charge port on either side. I cannot stress how many times that would have been extremely convenient when, say, a gas vehicle has blocked a charge spot of some sort. And that is it for charge ports. Settings and everything is a little limited on this car. Maybe we'd get more information once we DC fast charge, but pretty much I couldn't figure out, and I did play around a little bit more with it off camera, I could not figure out how to adjust amperage, just the charge levels. And let's see, who makes the charge cable? Delphi. And based on, oh, made in USA. Wow. Specs of the mobile charge cable: up to 240 volts, 40 amp, 60 hertz, type 3S, not sure what that means, but looks like this will charge as quickly as the original first and second gen Tesla mobile connectors, although Tesla has lowered the specs on the third gen mobile connector to 32 amp max. This will pump, looks like, up to 40 amp, and it also says 30 volts, 2 amp. That could be the communication pins. And that is it for charging.